This video describes efficiency improvements we're making in Microsoft Defender for Office 365 to help you get more done in less time. Malicious actors are sending higher volumes of email using advancing attack methods. As a result, SecOps frequently investigates security alerts arising from these emails and users' online interactions. Your goal is to prevent malicious emails from these attacks from reaching your users. On top of that, you must also verify that attackers compromised no users and no mailboxes if users interacted with any of the delivered email. That's a lot, and it can sometimes feel overwhelming for a stretched SecOps team. So, we're rolling out three big improvements to Defender for Office 365 that will help to directly reduce the number of malicious automated investigations requiring approval, prioritizing only the most malicious ones that really need your attention. Previously, automated investigation showed emails that were initially visible to users at the original delivery location, along with removal recommendations, even if those emails no longer pose a threat at the latest delivery location. Of course, we don't think that's very efficient. So, our first big change is that investigations, for things like zero-hour auto-purge and user submissions, will trigger pending email actions only when a malicious email's latest delivery location is a user's inbox or junk mail folder. While this change rolls out, you might still see pending email actions for Zap investigations. Review and approve those actions to remove any residual email threats. But in the future, you'll see more current location information with fewer email actions required, especially for Zap investigations. No automated investigation happens in isolation. Remediations from Zap, manual actions, and approved actions in one can make actions in another unnecessary. But you'd still have to review them anyway. Not anymore. To help make you more efficient, we'll periodically reevaluate an investigation's findings and actions against an email's latest delivery location and then update its remediation status. This continues until you approve or reject its actions. What you're going to experience is a big improvement to your productivity. First, if all malicious emails with pending actions are already removed from mailboxes, we'll just cancel any pending actions. Similarly, if remediations from other investigations have completed an investigation's email actions, we'll change its status to remediated and close the original alerts. The net result is that there will be fewer things to look at and click on. The last big change is to how we surface threats. First, we're changing our email analysis to use the latest Defender for Office 365 threat categories. Those include malware, high-confidence phishing, normal phishing, and spam. These categories help you prioritize the most critical malicious threats in an investigation, like a credential theft URL, over items that are simply suspicious. As well, investigations now create recommended actions only for emails and clusters that we determine to be the most critical threats. These changes help you to compare apples to apples, so you can focus on truly malicious emails. In Defender for Office 365, latest delivery locations, investigation reevaluation, and new threat types will help give SecOps teams clearer and more accurate information while focusing on fewer actions. So, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs to learn more about these changes.